We'll be solving a problem, example number 4, on no load and short circuit test. It says that there is a 5 kVA 400 to 200 volt transformer which is working on 50 hertz, and it's a single phase transformer, and the no load condition is given to you and a short circuit condition is given to you. So we have to find the component of no load current as well as R0 and X0, and we have to find the efficiency in voltage regulation at full load and the power factor is 0.8 lag. So in the open circuit test, we have studied about the R0 and X0 are formed by your no load components as well as your R1, X1, Z1 are formed by short circuit component. We'll see in this example how they are formed. By no load condition, we know that W1, which I was saying, is equal to V1 into I0 into cos phi. Since V1 is also given, I0 is also given, cos phi is also given, cos phi is not given actually, W1 is also given, that is 50 watts. So I can write one here, W1 by V1 is equal to I0 cos phi. But this I0 cos phi is nothing but the IC, which is the core loss component. So I will be able to find IC here. And IC is, I will be getting as 50 by 400. Which is approximately 0.125 ampere of the current. Now, since I got IC, I can get I0 now. Which is I0 is 1 amperes that is given. I got IC also, which is 0.125 amperes. So now I can get the magnetizing component of the component, which is I5 is equals to I0 minus IC square. So this will come out to me 1 square minus of 0.125 square for under root, and this is coming exactly as 0.992 amperes. So from this I got IC also, I got I5 also, magnetizing component. Now if I want R0 and X0, this is the component of no load. We are not required to find the parameters, so we will not be finding the parameters, but we can find the parameters also. By V1 upon I0 cos phi would be given the R0, and V1 upon I0 sin phi will be giving me the X0. So I can find R0 and X0 also, but since this is not requiring this exact, so we will not find it. Now we will be coming to the efficiency in voltage regulation, but for that I need to have something else. First of all, to know the efficiency or voltage regulation, I need to have the current which should be flowing in the as I1 and R1 and X1 also. So we will be finding R1 now. So I can find R1 by short circuit test, which will be saying that W1 or WSC upon ISC square will be giving me the R1 directly. So here the short circuit voltage is 40 divided by ISC, which is the short circuit current, that is 10 amperes, which means 100 divided by, which is 0.4 amperes. I'll 0.4 ohm I'll be getting as R1. In the same way, I can find the Z1 also, which will be given by VSC upon ISC, which is 12 volts here, and divided by 10, which is equals to again 1.2 ohm. So I can get x1 now by formula z1 square minus r1 square 4 into 2. I can put these values, which is equals to 1.2 square minus of 0.4 square, which is exactly coming as 1.13 ohm. So now I found x1 also. Now I need to have the full load current, since it is on the it is on the low voltage side, which is not written over there. This is HV side, this is again HV side. Both the things are done on HV side, not short circuit test was supposed to be done on the low voltage side, but it is done on high voltage side in the question. So what will we doing? We will be finding the I1 right now, which is the primary current, I1, which should actually flow in the transformer by 5000, which is the KVA, 5 KVA rating I have, divided by 400, which is exactly coming as 12.5 amperes. Now we have two formulas, two different formulas for efficiency and voltage regulation. You see those. We have already studied those formulas. So we'll be finding the voltage regulation first of all, percentage regulation. We know this formula, I1 into R1 cos phi plus or minus I1 into X1 sin phi divided by V1, since I am taking 1 only, I1 R1, so I will be taking V1 right now. So we have found the value of I1, we are known with R1 also, we know cos phi also, I1 also, X1 also, sin phi also, V1 also. So according to this, if I put the values, I1 I got as 12.5 amperes multiplied by R1 I got 0.4 into cos phi is 0.8 plus or minus. This is a very important thing. For lagging, we are using plus, and for leading, we are using minus. This is very important thing. Plus is used for lagging and minus is used for leading. This is very important thing. You should remember this thing. So here I will be using plus because of, since it's a power factor is lagging over here. And then I1 X1 will come 12.5 into X1 I got as 1.2 into sin phi is 0.6 because cos 0.8 will be equals to approximately 86 point something something, and sin of 86 point something something is 0.6, and V1 is 400. So by solving this thing, I will be getting a voltage regulation as 3.13%. Sorry, here there is a slight mistake with the value I put. This is not 12.5, I got X1 as 1.13. Even is the same from this one, I got X1 as 1.13, and the total Z1 was 1.2. So, this is the percentage regulation I will be getting in example number 4. Now coming to the efficiency part. Efficiency I can find by the formula X percentage of full load into power factor into divided by X percentage of full load KVA into power factor plus a PI plus PC, XPC square. Since X is full loaded, so X is 1 right now, so I will be omitting X here. I'll be omitting x from here. So full load KDA I'll be having as 5000 into power factor is 0.8 divided by again 5000 into 0.8 plus PI, iron losses. This is the iron loss from the no load test. Plus, I have the short circuit test. I have the copper losses also. That is 40 watt. So by solving this thing, I will be getting something in percentage, and that will be done by you people.